Hello everyone, in this video we are just going to learn about one of the service that is available in the ThinkSpeak IoT platform, that is this TalkBack service. Let's get started. So this TalkBack is nothing but a queue of commands that you can configure for controlling the IoT device. So you can directly pass the commands available in this TalkBack queue to our IoT device NodeMCU, and using that command received, we can control the operations that is held in the IoT device. So let's learn in detail how this TalkBack service is functioning. And now you can see this is the queue of TalkBack commands, and in each of these columns we will be having separate commands, and this queue can be as much as long as possible. So you can store as much as commands as per your need, and then you can use those commands for controlling the IoT device, that is the NodeMCU. And now let's assume that the commands available over here in this queue are L1, L2, L3, L4 and L5, and each of these commands will be provided with the position number, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. You can see the one on the right is the first command position, one on the extreme left is the final fifth command position. And other than this position, we are also having an ID for each of the commands, which is named as command ID. So let's assume the command ID of the first command to be 1001, and this one is having 1002, 1003, 1004, and finally this one is having 1005. But the fact is that we cannot assign this command ID. Instead, when you create each of these commands, the ThinkSpeak server itself will be providing an ID for that command. So we will be providing only the position of the command as well as the command data available over here. So this L1 will be provided by us, which is the command, and this position number 1 will be provided by us for storing the command. And once stored, you can use this command or you can pass this command from here to the IoT device for controlling the IoT device. And further, you can see these are all the operations that you can perform on each of the commands available in the TalkBack service. That is, you can firstly add a command, you can add a new commands as per your wish, and then you can update a command. So as per your need, you can change the command over here by using the command ID. So that is called updating a command. And nextly, you can read the command by using the command ID and the API key. You can read the command available over here in the current position of the command. And nextly, you can execute the commands. So each command can be executed so that the corresponding command can be sent to the IoT device. So let us discuss in detail about each of these actions that can be performed on the TalkBack commands, and we will be demonstrating all of these processes one by one. So this TalkBack service is most widely useful for storing commands in a queue as per your requirement. And further, you can use these commands available in this queue for controlling the IoT devices. Now let's try to create a TalkBack. Just click on this TalkBack, just log into your ThinkSpeak account, and then click on this apps and click on TalkBack. Now here, click on this new TalkBack for creating a TalkBack. And here we just want to give a name for the TalkBack, TalkBack test 1. And here you can see our TalkBack is having a separate API key that is provided by the ThinkSpeak server. And then you just want to provide the channel at which you just want to create the TalkBack. Select the current channel that we have been using till now, and that's it. You can see our TalkBack has been now ready to be created. And before that, you can see we can manually create commands over here. That is, we can manually perform all these operations available over here. That is, we can add a command, we can update a command, we can read a command, and then we can execute a command. And now initially we will see how we can manually create the commands. Just click on this add a new command, and here, as I said, we just want to provide two things, that is the position number and the command that you want to store. And regarding this command ID, as I said, this command ID is usually provided by the ThingSpeak server. So I will give the same position number and the command that is required. So the command is L1 and the position is 1. So here I'm just giving position is 1 and command is L1. And I'm clicking on add a new command again, and then I'm just going to add further commands L2, 3, L3, 4, L4, 5, L5, and that's it. That's all about the commands that I want to create. Now I'm just clicking on this save talkback for creating the talkback. And you can see these are all the commands that I created, and for each command a separate command ID has been created by the ThingSpeak IoT platform. And here you can see this is the command string L1, L2, L3, L4 and L5, and positions are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and these are all the command IDs. So this command IDs need not to be in a sequential manner because it will be allocating a free space for each of these commands. And that's it. By clicking on this add a new command, you can create a new command, or you can also edit this talkback for removing a command. Just click on this remove command for removing a command. And you can see this is the API key generated for this talkback, and this is the talkback ID. So each and every talkback that you create will be having a separate ID, and it will be provided with the API key. And as I said, these are all the process that you can do on these commands: add a command, update a command, read a command, and execute a command. And for these operations, the request format in HTTP is provided over here. You can see this is the post request format for adding a new command, and this is the get request format for reading a command from the command ID, and this is the put request format for updating a talkback command. And this is the post request format for executing a commands available in the talkback. So that's all about the things. We just want to use this post request for adding a talkback command, and we are just going to use this get request for reading the commands available in the command ID, respective command ID, and then we are just going to use this put request for updating the commands available over here using the command ID, and then we will be using this post request again for executing the next talkback available in the queue of the talkback menu. And let's try to test each of these things. That is, I'm just going to add a new command L6 to this queue. So I'm just copying this post request. And since this is a post request, our browser is not capable of doing this post request. So we are just going to use another app called Postman. So here click on this postman.com, and by clicking on this button, you can directly download and install the Postman app required for your PC. And then open this Postman. Till the previous lecture, we have been using only the get request for adding the data to the channel available in the ThingSpeak and for reading the data from the channel available in the ThingSpeak. And since the get request is supported by the browser right over here, we have not used any other app, but here we just want to give a post request. So this is a different kind of request in HTTP format protocol. So for sending this post request and put request, we will be using this Postman app, And also you can generate a get request from this also. You can see these are all the supported requests by this Postman app. You can either send a get request, or you can send a post request, or you can send a put request to the web services from this Postman app. And now let's try to add a command. Now I'm just copying this and I'm pasting it in this Postman. Now you can see, you just want to give a question mark over here. Now you can see this is the TalkBack ID. Now you can see this is the TalkBack ID and this one is the API key. So these two things may be varying in your URL. You don't want to search for anything. You can just find it here in the TalkBack menu itself. All the parameters will be available over here. You just want to copy the URL. And in your URL, you will be having a different API key and the TalkBack ID. And further, you just want to add a command by concatenating it. Ampersand of command string, ampersand of command string is equal to L6. And once done, you can see I'm just going to add the L6 command to the queue available over here. That is, to this queue I'm just going to add L6 command, and I'm just going to pass this post request. So select post request over here and then click on send. Now you can see here the ID has been created and the command has been created successfully. Now when I open this ThingSpeak TalkBack page, I'm refreshing it, you can see a new command has been added. And that's it. You, using this post request URL available over here, you can add the commands to the TalkBack queue. And nextly, using this get request available here, you can read the command available in the TalkBack queue. For example, using this command ID, you can directly read it. And since this is a get request, get HTTP request, you can directly use the Google Chrome browser, or you can also use this Postman app. I'm just going to use the web browser, and the only thing that we want to change is this command ID. So I want to copy paste the command ID required. If you want to read this L2, I'm just copying this and I'm pasting it in this place of command underscore ID. And that's it. You can see this is the API key. This will be varying in your case and the command ID. So in this place, you just want to give the command ID of which command you are going to read. And this is the TalkBack ID. You will be having a different TalkBack ID. And when I click on enter, since this is a get request, I'm getting a response from the Google Chrome. And if it is a post or put request, you just want to use this Postman. And you can also send a get request from this Postman also. That is not a problem. For better visibility, I'm just using this Google Chrome browser. Now you can see this is the response that I got. The ID is given over here and the command is L2. As we know, the L2 command is the copied command. We are getting the L2. And if I copy any other command ID and if I paste it over here, the same get request URL, you can see I get the command to be L3. Now when I copy this L6 command ID, I get the command L6. So in this manner, you can use this get request available over here for reading the command that is available in the TalkBack queue with the respective command ID. So I'm just going to show you how you can send this get request from the Postman. I'm just deleting all these things. Now when I search for this command ID 4, I just want to paste it in this command ID position. change this request to be get and then send. Now you can see the command that I received is L4 right over here. So you can also send a get request, post request, put request and all these requests with the help of this postman to any web service required. For testing the web service, you can use this postman app. And nextly, let us see about the update talkback command. So this is another kind of request available in the HTTP protocol. Now here I'm just copying this and I'm going to paste it here in the Postman app. And as usual, we are just going to give a question mark over here. And here you can see in this URL, this is the API key of the talkback and this one is the talkback ID. And regarding the ID, let's take, I just want to update this L6 to be L7. So I'm just copying this command ID and I'm going to paste it here in the command ID position. And here you just want to concatenate these things, that is ampersand of command string is equal to L7. So in place of this L6 command that is available in the command ID of 233189991, I just want to replace this L6 command with the L7. That is, I just want to update the command L6 with L7. So for that, I am just writing this line ampersand of command underscore string is equal to L7. And nextly, change this to be put request as given over here. For updating a talkback command, you just want to use the put request, put HTTP request, and then click on send. Now you can see for this command ID, the command string has been changed to L7. The process is successful. The request is successful. Now, when I refresh this, you can see the command has been changed to L7. So, in this manner, you can update a particular command string available in the respective command ID using the same command ID using this put request format available over here. And for executing the command, we are just going to use this post request. So executing in the sense is nothing but each of the command will be executed one by one. As I said, this is a queue. Firstly, when you execute a command, this L1 will be sent. And nextly, when you execute the same talkback, we will get this L2. Nextly, we will get this L3, L4, L5 and L6. So in this order, since this is a queue, we will get all these commands one by one when you execute the command using this post request available over here. I'm just copying this and I'm pasting it over here. And here I'm just going to give a question mark. Now you can see this URL is having the host name followed by the talkback, and then here we are having talkback ID. And we are giving the action to be execute and we are having the API key. And I'm changing this to be post request. Now when I click on send, as this is a queue, I will get this L1 first. As you can see, when I send this, I will get the command string L1 that is available over here in the first line of the queue, that is the position 1 of the queue. And when I again send this execute post request, I will get the second command, that is L2, that is available in the second position of the queue. Again I will get the L3, L4, L5 and then I will get L7. You can see when I execute again L3 I am getting, then I am getting L4, then I am getting L5, then I am getting L7. So in this manner you can execute this talkback, and each time when you execute you will get each of the commands available in a queue manner, that is from the position 1 till the n position. Again when I execute, you can see I am getting a null character because all the commands in the talkback queue has been executed. So we have demonstrated all these processes, that is, we have added a command using the post request and then we updated a command using the put request available over here, and then we read the command using the get request available over here, and then we executed the command using the post request that is available over here. So in each of these command request available, you will be getting a different API key and the talkback ID, and you don't want to worry about that. These things will be available here in this ThingSpeak website inside this talkback menu. So you can copy this and then you can use this. The only changes that we made is in this get talkback ID, you just want to provide the command ID, that is whatever the command that you want to read, the corresponding command ID, you just want to provide it over here, and don't forget to give this question mark that will be erased sometimes in the postman. And here also you just want to give the command ID when sending this put request for updating your talkback command. And regarding this execute, you can directly use this. And regarding this post request, you just want to concatenate it with the command string equal to required command string. So this is important for adding a command to the queue. So you just want to add this in addition to the post request available over here. And for reading the talkback, you just want to give only the command ID for reading the command string required. And then for updating the command also, you just want to provide the command string is equal to updated command string. You just want to give it over here. And further, for executing, you just want to use the same URL without making any change to the post request. And that's it for this lecture. We have manually performed all these actions in the talkback. And from the next lecture, we will try to perform all these actions with the help of NodeMCU IoT device. See you in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.